how to buy used hot dog carts for sale. Okay, we're going to talk about all the stuff on how to buy used hot dog carts for sale. And what that will do for you is help you buy used hot dog carts and not get screwed. So it's a win-win situation. Here's what I'm going to cover. That's actually a real customer. That is one of our customers right there on the screen. Real customer. Pretty freaking cool. So used carts versus new carts. Okay. Let's talk about that real quickly, and then we'll go from there. And what I'm going to cover is where to find carts, inspecting the cart, what's a good price, beware of scams, titles and documents, and then we'll be done. I'll try to rush through this quickly. I'm going to talk fast. So get your thinking caps on, grab a pen and paper, and jot down some notes. If you don't have a pen and paper, hit pause right now and grab a pen and paper, because you don't want to miss this, and it's going to help you make the best decision and get the best price on a cart that you find used for sale. A used hot dog cart for sale. Like, if you came to me and said, how can I buy a used hot dog cart for sale? That's what I'm going to help you do. So let's talk about used versus new. Okay. There are lots of new carts out there. Not nearly as the risk involved when you're buying from a reputable company. If the company's been in business a while and you can look up and do your due diligence and like Google the heck out of them and go, okay, they got 11,000 so customers on Facebook and they got good reviews on blogs and forums and stuff they can't control, then great. There's also websites you can check out like Ripoff Report and stuff like that. And so you can kind of get a good feel on a new, if you're buying a new cart from a company. There are some companies though that have been out there for years who still make junk. But there's plenty of good companies too. But what we're talking about today is buying used, because in my opinion, and even though this is contrary to, capitalism, is because we manufacture carts, so why in the world would I teach you about buying a freaking used hot dog cart? Because I love you, number one. Number two is because I can't sell every cart, you know, that anybody wants, as far as I can't sell all the carts. It's impossible. So there are used carts for sale. Why not get one? Get out of the red quicker. Get into the black faster. And let your used cart that you bought, that you saved money on, pay for your new cart. Maybe you want some, you know, bibbity boppity boo Cadillac cart one day. Well, let it pay for it. Maybe you want a concession trailer, a concession truck. Let that used cart pay for it. Why spend the money when you don't have to, right? It's why we created that Build a Cart course. You can go buildacart.com and you can build a cart for under $900. We show you step by step. Not me per se, but my partner and engineer, Keith, walks you step by step through how to build a cart from scratch, no matter what tools you have. And he shows you different methods, different tools, different everything. If it can be done with multiple tools, he'll show you each way. And so that's a possibility. But you can buy used carts. You can get good deals. I've seen people get them from $300 to $500 to $1,000. But different times of year are different with used carts. So in the spring, in the summer, they're typically higher, usually higher than a new one. Why, you ask? Glad you asked. New carts usually take, you know, a week, 10 days, something like that to get to you if you order one. But a used cart in your hometown, you can just run over there, grab the cart, pull it home, you're good to go. So that's another benefit. It's instant. It's immediate gratification. As long as everything checks out, which we're going to cover all that in a minute. I'm going to cover a lot of stuff with you, and I'll try not to make this long, but the problem is I hear from so many people that make mistakes, and so I wanted to update the video. I already had a video about buying used carts, but I wanted to make, grab some new information that I've learned over the years and update it. So I hope this helps you. I hope that now you can go buy a used cart, and I'm going to tell you where to find the best deals and how to negotiate and all that stuff. But I want you to get a good deal so that you can be profitable instantly instead of longer term. So let's talk about this more. Finding a used cart. There are several ways, places to find a used cart. Craigslist is probably my favorite, even though there's some risks involved, and we're going to talk about that in a little bit. But Craigslist.org will give you, you know, it asks you to pick a state and then a city, or an area and then a city. The problem with Craigslist is there are some scammers, and I'm going to go over that with you, so don't panic. But Craigslist will The only real drawback is you can't search like a area with Craigslist. You pick a city, you know? So, if there's five local areas or cities around you, you have to go to each one. And then there's two parts to it. There's categories in those cities. So you have all the for sale items and you could search hot dog carts and you'd want to try different spellings because some people put the hot dog together. Some people put it separate and you want to check that when you're searching. But search your area, then go to another area and search it. Any area that you're willing to drive, and we'll go into that more in just a bit. So there's categories. The other category is so you got the for sale everything. Then you have a business category, which people, you know, they've listed in the business category, which won't show up typically in the for sale category. So even though it's for sale, and go figure. So then you have to go to the business category and do the same thing for each county, city, state, you know, that you're looking for a cart. A little bit time consuming, but well worth it. Saves you some money. Within an hour, you could hit everybody within driving distance and know, okay, I want to look at these four carts. Now, eBay, same deal. People spell it different, and there's about a blue million categories. There's commercial kitchen, there's industrial, there's vending, there's hot dog carts, there's food carts, food trucks, catering carts. There's like a blue million freaking category. So you have to search each one because typically it won't pull them all up. Now eBay's a little better than Craigslist and pulling up multiple categories, but you still need to do your due diligence. And if you're going to invest in something that is and will make you over $100,000 a year, then why not spend an hour or two and do your due diligence and find the right stuff? There's a website called Search Tempest, searchtempest.com. You can see it there on your screen. SearchTempest.com looks at multiple Craigslist and eBay areas. You can search just Craigslist. You can search a whole region instead of having to go through itemized areas. Okay. So Search Tempest, remember that. Ad Hunter is another one. ADHUNTR, not an apostrophe R, but that's their logo is apostrophe. You can do that and get to multiple listings. There's also another website, and I'm going to give you a hack for it. It's usevending.com. Usevending.com is a larger website that covers the entire country. And here's what they do. You have a cart for sale, and you want to list it there. They go, hey, listen, we'll take all the calls. We'll deal with all the headaches and the people, blah, 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 blah. And what do you want to sell it for? You want to sell it for $3,000? Then they have it listed for $4,500 or whatever they list it for. They put a markup on it, and then they take the calls. They don't even list your information, contact information, or anything on there. And then they work out the deal, and if they get an interested party, they send them to you. And they tell you, hey, we've sold this customer this price. That's how they make their money. But I've learned from some other vendors who are savvy little suckers, little hackers, who showed me that you could actually find keywords in those listings. So if you go to usevending.com and you find a cart you like and it's in your area, which usually will show you the area it's in, state or city or county or something, and may say South Florida, whatever it is, you look at it and go, yeah, I'm definitely interested in that. Then jump over to Craigslist and use any keywords that are in that ad. And you'll typically find it on Craigslist because most people who put it there have also put it on Craigslist and trying to sell it themselves as well. So, and you'll save that upcharge. So it's kind of a great place to go find a cart. You can buy directly through them, but you can also, if you can find the cart, I know of two people recently that found a cart elsewhere, you know, found it there and then went somewhere else and searched on Craigslist and found it. There's also some local classified. So if you live in Chicago, they got ChicagoClassifieds.com or something like that. And you can go there and look up local classifieds. There's also Facebook pages. So you can search hot dog cart classifieds or hot dog carts for sale and look through those and you'll find stuff in your area. So that's a great hack. But before we go further, do not, whatever you do, do not go and buy a cart sight unseen. If you're buying new, way better odds. But if you're buying used, if you've done your due diligence on the new, you know, the company itself, you're okay. But you buying used, you can get hammered. I've heard horror stories of people buying stuff and never seeing it, thinking they're going to get it. And we'll talk about the scams later. So always you want to see it because even if the person is legit and they legitimately have a hot dog cart for sale, or a food vending cart or a catering cart or whatever you want to call it. Because these carts will do anything. They're basically mobile kitchens. if somebody has one for sale, it doesn't mean it works perfectly. And we're going to go into that, and I'm going to tell you what to look for. I'm going to tell you what to take. I'm going to walk you through it step by step. And hopefully you have the patience to stick with me through this, because I will save you money. And it's free. It's free information. Okay. I probably would do better if I charged people for the information, because more people would actually take it serious. But instead, some people will listen to half this video, call me up, you know, 6 weeks from now and go, man, I bought a bad cart. And think they got screwed or whatever. But if you'll stick with me through this, you're going to find out, you're going to get the best deal. You'll have negotiating power, because what I'm going to teach you in here in just a second, and you'll be able to find a used hot dog cart for sale that probably get the best price than anyone else that would show up. All right. So here's where it gets, here's the nitty gritty. Inspecting the cart. There's four things I want you to take when going to look at a cart. Let's say you found one and it's the next county over, it's in your city or whatever. There's four things I want you to take, and I want you to be very, there's five actually, but four crucial ones. And then we'll take it from there. You want a bottle of soapy water. You're going, why? Because we're going to make, those pretty bubbles. Not really. We want to discover bubbles, and that's why we want soapy water. Propane tank. Yes, a propane tank, just a small propane tank like you'd put in your backyard grill, 20-pounder it's called, and that will, you need to take one. And there's a reason why, and I'm going to get to it in a second. You'll need to take a magnet. Take a magnet with you. You're going, why do I need a magnet? I promise. Take a refrigerator magnet. It doesn't matter what kind. Just take a magnet. Thermometer. Take a thermometer. So that's it. The fifth one, if you take, that I would advise is a small battery, like a 12-volt. Needs to be 12-volt motorcycle or lawnmower battery. It's the small battery. So let's talk about why's to take soapy water. Soapy water is going to determine if there's any leaks, okay? Because anywhere gas is leaking, you're going to find it with soapy water. And so I'd mix it pretty thick. You know, I'd take your little squirt bottle that you use to clean and, you know, put three or four tablespoons, like double the dilution that you would normally do, or double the concentrate as you normally do, and take that little spray bottle. You want a spray bottle so you can get to the places you can't reach. Okay. You could wipe it with a soapy rag, but if you can't reach it, it's way better to take a spray bottle, spray it, and you'll see the bubbles if there's a leak. So, you get to the location, you bring your propane tank. You may not need it, but I have had experiences where they go, oh, I don't have a propane tank. And they don't have a propane tank because they don't want you to know that there's 900 leaks in the system. So if they have a propane tank, it probably means there's no leak, but I'd still check it. So take your propane tank, hook it up. Okay. If they already have one, you don't need to, but you still need to take it. So you have it. Turn it on, then go up to the front of the cart. There should be valves there that control each burner, depending on how many burners there are. Those should be off. Okay. Spray the burners first. If the burners bubble, that means the valves are bad. That means the valves are leaking gas. Okay. Then, now I'm going to go through a bunch of potential problems. I want you to know this, so I don't have to keep repeating it. None of these are life altering or mean, hey, don't take the deal, because I'm going to tell you what this does for you. So, you then spray the valves, then turn them on real quick and spray around them and turn them off and, you know, turn them on for a little bit and see if they leak. Okay. And around the actual knob, then turn them back off. So you're not blowing out gas. You'll want to make sure that you have at least a couple cigarettes lit during this process. If you like your hair being singed off, I'm just kidding. Don't have any fire around you. So then take, and run the rest of the gas line. Cause now it's under pressure. Okay. The gas line's under pressure from the front of the cart all the way to the gas tank. And you want to check all the way, spraying every inch, every centimeter of that line, and that soapy water will stick to the line. And anywhere there's a leak, a connection, a joint, or even just a small hole, there will be bubbles starting to come up because of that soapy water. Not the end of the world, but you'll want to know. Okay. So, especially, there's a few morons that actually put in galvanized pipe, for their propane, for their water, just freaking morons. And other things. I've seen the stupidest stuff used for piping. Not that you can't fix that problem, but always check everything. Spray it. So you've checked that. No leaks, let's say, or even if there is leaks, bottom line is you know. Now, that's why you have the propane tank. So we've covered two in one right there. See how quick I am? Now a magnet. You go, why a magnet? Take a magnet. This is a picture of a Hot Diggity Dogs vendor with a big dog cart, and he's got stickers, you know, vinyl stickers on the side. Those aren't magnets. if a magnet sticks to the side of that cart, anywhere that's supposed to be stainless, if it sticks, ain't stainless, just so you know. It's just junk metal, basically metal that's going to rust, metal that's just inferior, weaker, cheaper, bleh. And there are manufacturers that say stainless steel cart and a magnet sticks to it. And there's some, there's a couple manufacturers that actually sell magnetic signs that they'll custom make for you for the carts and then tell you that it's stainless steel. And the whole time, stainless steel doesn't take magnets. So you bought your fancy fridge at Sears and you go, and I'm just picking on Sears, but any Lowe's, Home Depot, any of them, they say stainless steel. You go stick a magnet to it, it ain't stainless steel. Okay? It's junk. Just fake steel. It's fake stainless. So that's why you take a magnet. Does this really matter? No. It's not that big a deal, but if you're paying for stainless, if they're advertising it as stainless, which is more expensive, which does last longer, which cleans easier, which is less porous of a material, and the health departments love it, then I'd want to get what I'm paying for. And so it gives you bargaining room. And that's why if there's a leak and you find it, bargaining room. You can go, oh, there's a leak. I'm going to have to replace these lines. That's a couple $100. You know, you just start whittling down the price. That's what the point of this is. Plus, you don't overspend. Thermometer, turn on the burners, okay? Actually light those suckers. Turn them on. Now, if you don't have pans in there, the person should have pans. If they don't have pans, you can't put wood over it, but you need something to stop the heat from going out of the hole. So I would, if you don't have pans to take with you, which I didn't even suggest taking pans, I probably wouldn't. If they're selling a hot dog cart, they should have pans, even if they're crappy pans. Put some water in them because some pans are aluminum. They look like stainless and they'll melt. So always put some water in the pans. Check the pans. And that's the sixth thing I'd tell you to take if you took anything is water. Okay. That way you can check their water system and everything. So, but they should have that. They should have water. So that's why it's not as important. So you're going to put the pans in to stop the heat from just escaping. Okay. Just like it was operational. Then you're going to take your thermometer, put it in the cooler and get a reading. Then you're going to leave it in the cooler for 15, 20 minutes while you inspect the rest of the cart, which we'll cover in a second. You'll come back and check that thermometer and you'll go, oh, it says 92 degrees. And here's what happens. Most manufacturers do not have a heat shield between the cooler and the steam table. So all carts create a little oven, so to speak, because you got fire inside that box. But I know very few manufacturers that actually put heat shields. We put a triple heat shield, and still there's a carryover of heat, but it's not near as bad. I mean, not even a fraction of a percent of bad. So you want to make sure that that cart has, it's not going to, every time you turn it on, melt everything in your cooler. So that's why you take a thermometer. You can pick up a thermometer at the dollar store for $3. And it's worth the expense. You know, it's worth, all these things are worth doing. They're a pain in the neck sometimes, but you may not have it readily available, but it's worth doing. It's going to save you lots of money if you check these things. You're going to want something to tap with. And you're going, why would I need to tap anything? I'll tell you why. There's a manufacturer in business in the U.S. right now. Been in business for years. I've taken in several of his carts as trade-ins. And because I know what I'm getting, and I have to show the person trading it in and go, okay, this is why this cart is not worth nearly what you think it's worth, is because there's no real metal here and here and here and here and here. This manufacturer actually uses it's like a plastic-coated cardboard on the inside of the bread box and on the inside of the propane tank box and in separations within the cart, underneath the cart, so that it looks like stainless, but it ain't. So you tap. And if you tap it, you're going to go, you know, when you tap metal, it goes ting, ting, ting. And when you tap cardboard, it makes a whole different sound. So now I'm not going to do the sound effects. So now you have an idea where, you know, if it's real metal, because can you imagine buying a stainless steel cart and driving down the road like I did once and your propane tanks, because it's raining, fall out of the bottom of the cart because the inside of the holding area for the propane tanks is completely cardboard and it wasn't even really metal. It was fake metal. And that manufacturer, although he's changed names 4 times in the last few years, he's, as far as I know, still does this. And so you have to watch that stuff. You have to look, and that's why you look, because you don't want to get into, I mean, none of this is life, you know, life altering. You can fix anything, but it gives you bargaining room. When you're standing there with the seller and you tap and go, oh, and you take your finger and scratch and go, this ain't even stainless. This is cardboard. You know, it's like a pressed paper product. And they go, oh, I didn't know that. And you go, well, that's not worth the crap. That makes this cart way less. So that's just one thing. That's why you tap. You want to look under the cart. Okay. You should have already been there when you checked the spray for the gas lines, but you want to look under the cart for the cooler. You want to make sure that cooler is completely insulated. The same manufacturer that does the, and he's pretty big. He sells a lot of carts. Okay. He does a drop-in sink. It's like a, you've seen those waste sinks, like a hand washing sink that you'd use in your garage. It's like fiberglass plastic tub. He uses that as a cooler and calls it a cooler. It's not a cooler. It's a plastic tub with no insulation. Now, is that the end of the world? No. You can insulate that. You can insulate it. You can wrap it. You can foam board it. You can grate stuff, you know, that expanding foam it. You can insulate the piss out of it and you'll be fine. But now you know. So I'd rather know and have the room to negotiate the price by pointing these things out to the seller, because more than likely, even the seller doesn't know. So you check your cooler, you check everything, you check the underneath, check for suspension. Okay. Underneath, some manufacturers actually do not put suspension on the trailers. Typically, these are not your longtime manufacturers. These are the ones that pop up in the spring and are gone by the end of summer. They just try to capitalize on the busy season of selling carts, and they buy junk and they put a fixed axle with no suspension to a frame, and it will beat the piss out of that cart within days. It's just junk. Can you still work around that? That's probably one I'd walk away from. If there's no suspension, no leaf spring whatsoever or spring system whatsoever, walk away from it. Because otherwise, unless it's not welded, if the frame's not welded to the axle, then you could add leaf springs maybe. It's probably still too big of a headache. I'd probably just walk away. So now let's talk about, so you looked under it, you've already sprayed, you've checked wiring, check everything, okay? Now, some cart manufacturers will cover the bottom. They will cover the whole thing so you can't see up there. Don't let that get by you. Unscrew it. Do whatever you need to do to look inside that cart, okay? I don't think they should be covered, because you are creating a... I think that's hiding stuff. Doesn't mean it is, but because I know one manufacturer that covers his, but all his stuff underneath is great. So it doesn't matter that he covers it. He covers it, he puts vents on the side and stuff like that. I don't think you need... I'd still check it. So you may want to take a screwdriver, but usually the seller should have a freaking screwdriver or something to take off the bottom so you can see. That way you'll know your size of your wastewater, freshwater tanks. You'll be able to look at that stuff. Let's talk about the water system real quick. Some cart manufacturers are, and some states still allow a gravity flow system, which means the tank is up high. It's in the bread box. Water line comes out of the tank over to the sinks. The hot line runs over the burners, okay? And that is your water flow. It's gravity flow. It's very slow. It trickles out. It's not the end of the world. Some states still accept it. But the last few years, many states have adopted a code which requires pressurized water systems on these carts. So you'll want to probably convert it either way. Conversion is not a big deal. It's not the end of the world if it's a gravity flow system. Just you can go to our site and get a heater, a water heater on demand, so it only heats when it needed. It only comes on when you turn on the water for the hot, a small battery and a pump. That's it. And hook on your line connections and you're good to go. It runs off your propane tank. You need a splitter for that. It's easy to do. Not a big deal, but you want to know, because most states don't accept it if it's gravity flow anymore. So you want a pressurized system. Burners, 1 versus 2 versus 3 and the BTUs. Let me tell you two different parts to this. Some manufacturers use chintzy burners. They use, there's one manufacturer actually going and buying grills, throwing away the grill and keeping the burner out of it, but it's cheap grills with this metal. It looks like stainless, but it changes color immediately. It's just junk. Those burners won't last you long. They probably won't last you a season. The next option is, real stainless steel burners, which are okay, but I still would rather have cast iron burners. They'll last as long as you ever want to vent. They'll last for decades. Just wire brush them, repaint them when you're not using it one day and with heat resistant paint, and they'll stay good forever. Okay. You don't really have to do much to those to keep those. I don't even paint mine. I just freaking wire brush them and let them go. They rust, but they're so freaking thick. It doesn't matter. 1 versus 2 versus 3 though, bigger issue. You get to a cart and it's got one burner problem, because let's say you have one steam table. And if you need information on steam tables, I have that free with outline. I got 3 videos on that. If you go to the free training on learnhotdogs.com, the video training, it will walk you through the more than you probably ever wanted to know about steam tables. But a full-size steam table, let's say you have a third-size pan that you don't want, you've boiled your dogs, but you don't want them to have any extra heat. You just want them to stay warm, but you don't want the fire on. Well, if it's one burner, you have no choice. You have fire on or fire off, but this stuff over here needs to stay hot. This stuff over here doesn't. You don't need to be on fire, and you can't adjust that. You can go up and down with the flame, but everything's getting heated evenly. That's not a good system. And there's some manufacturers that sell it that way. Not a good system. Usually those manufacturers aren't in business the next year, but that's the way it is. The more burners, the better is the bottom line. So if you've got a 2 burner system and two knobs, excellent. Three, even better, okay? Three, you can control all kinds of temperature. So, and you can have this one on high and this one on low and that kind of stuff. Now you want to fire it up, okay? And we already talked about fire it up and the insulation, so I'm not going to go over the insulation, but I want you to fire it up. I want you to turn it on and check all that stuff out that I told you earlier. But you also want to check while you're doing that the flame height. Will the flame go from low to high? Because here's what some manufacturers do. They go and buy some cheap cast iron burner or some or valve system that basically is on or off. It may have a dial, but it's on or off. It's high or nothing. And then some even go further than that and get something that's 100,000 BTU and it just like the power of seven suns. It's, and that ain't good. Okay. It ain't good for your cart. It ain't good for nothing. Unless you're doing a turkey out in the woods camping or something, you need to heat up grease quick. It's dumb. You want somewhere your burners to be between, if they don't know, there's not really anything you can do, but you can kind of tell by the flame. But 9,000 to about 20,000 max BTU each. And so 9,000 to 20,000 BTU each on the burners. If there's one, two, or three, one, I don't like. If you have one, I'd replace the gas system and put in two burners at minimum. Three is best. Especially if it's a larger steam table. So now you have an idea on your burners. You want to crank them up and down, see if they actually adjust. Some of them don't, some of them do. Even though it feels like it's adjusting, the flame doesn't change. It's just on or off. So keep that in mind. Cooler insulation, I already talked about. Size of your water tanks is important. You know, most states want your wastewater tank to be 15, some want 20, some want 25%, and some want 50% larger than your freshwater tank. So if your freshwater's 5, they want your wastewater 7.5 minimum. And that's our standard because, that way it covers all states. So you got a 5-gallon fresh, 7.5-gallon waste, you're good to go. So if you already know when you go what your tank size should be, you'll be able to look at those tanks, see how easy they are to waste, to clean out the waste. Most states require you clean out the fresh, you know, to rinse it out, with a sanitization, solution, which is sanitizing solution, which is just, you know, a teaspoon of bleach and a gallon of water. And you can rinse it out. And that way you have, a bacteria free environment in your pipes and everything. So you've looked at that. Now, does any of these major things other than the suspension that I already told you about matter? They only matter on what you spend because you can spend too much and then go, oh, now I got to put $600 into this or, hey, I got him to discount at $600 because I knew I was going to have to spend $600. That's why. Ultimately, though, I have people that call me that have made bad decisions that paid way too much. I've had people call me and bought a big dog cart. They buy on my website for $3,000. They bought it for $5,500 in Arizona and they go, oh my gosh, I didn't even know you existed. And then I saw your tag and then I saw blah, blah, blah. And I called you and I didn't know you had I didn't even know. And it's not uncommon. Don't feel bad. It happens. Here's the nice part. That cart's going to pay for itself either way. Okay. One, it may take a couple weeks or 3 weeks longer. So don't beat yourself up if you already bought one and you didn't check all that stuff out because it happens. Okay. Good price. What's a good price? This is a Cater Pro cart, shown with the commercial griddle. It's a monster of a cart, two full size steam tables and all that stuff. We have it at hotdogcartstore.com if you want to see the video and stuff on it. But that is, that and the Big Dog are two most popular carts. And it, you know, has four sink standard. It's just a sexy cart. It works great for catering. It works, it'll outwork you. You'd need two or three people to even keep up with it if you were running it at full capacity. The bottom line is you can find these on Craigslist, probably. They'll probably be $7,000 to $10,000. And you go, well, why would somebody try to sell that for $7,000 to $10,000 when I can buy it from you for $4,000, you know? Well, it's because they can, because most people want immediate gratification. They want to buy it yesterday. They don't want to wait 2 weeks for shipping. So, they buy it. There's a guy, I have a customer that's been buying carts for me for 3 years, roughly 5 to 10 a month average. So you could safely say seven carts a month. That's a lot of carts. That's 96 a year, roughly. And he sells them on Craigslist. He sells them on Craigslist, but he marks them up $1,000 to $1,500 more. And he doesn't take off our labels or anything. He goes, yep, it's a brand new cart. Still warranty, everything. Here it is. And for those that look it up and they go, well, why are you selling it for more than this? Well, it's here. Number one, you can order from Ben, but it's, you know, now you have to wait, you know, 10 days or 7 days or whatever, depending on where you are. And it works. I don't have a problem with that. So what I'm telling you is used carts or new carts, you're going to find hold their value. And if they're kept decently clean, they're going to hold their value for eons. I've seen carts that are 15 years old sell for as much as a brand new cart. So don't let that bother you. If you pay too much, it just means it takes a little longer to get into the black. Not a freaking big deal. While the color fades, I'm going to smoke a little bit of my cigarette. What I do want to talk about, though, is scams. Because scams are, very common on Craigslist. It's probably the most common. eBay, you're a lot safer, but eBay doesn't have as many opportunities and as good a pricing because they pay so many fees, where Craigslist doesn't pay any fees for you to sell. They charge you nothing. You can go directly between buyer and seller, where eBay kind of tracks everything, which creates some security in the transaction, but it also, that security costs you more because the person selling it, a used car, is paying more for his transaction. So he builds that into the price and then you'll pay fees. So the bottom line is scams are abundant. Here's how to avoid it. Don't buy anything used you can't go touch. Don't say, ship it to me. Don't believe any BS you hear and you'll be safe. There, I can give you probably over 40 stories over the last 5 or 6 years that I'm personally aware of where somebody was scammed on Craigslist. Not that Craigslist is bad. It's a great place. It's my favorite resource for finding good deals. And you'll find real good deals on carts, trucks, and trailers that are concession related in the late fall and winter. And you get to the end of winter and they start going up and up and up and up and up in price. And then spring is, you know, crazy. So, unless you can go see it, I don't care what the story is. My uncle's, nephew's, cousin's, neighbor's chickens having puppies. And so he can't, we already have the cart in storage and he's in Iraq serving the military. Hoorah. Gives you some BS story. Don't believe anything. Because it's BS. And I'll put money on 99.99999% of them are BS. If they tell you, you can't come see the cart. They tell you to send them some money and then they're going to send you the cart or tell you the code to their little combination lock at the U-Haul, storage facility or whatever. It's BS. Don't ever do it. Don't do it. Don't do it. So that's how you avoid scams. Go look before you buy, which you should have been doing anyway. That's the reason for this freaking video. Title and paperwork. Okay. I'm going to cut to the chase. You can buy without a title as long as you know that your state, county, city, whatever tag agency will issue you a title on a vehicle without a title. And it's considered a vehicle. It's a cart. It's something that travels down the road. So it's under the laws of the federal DOT, Department of Transportation. Now, some states don't want tags. They don't even care if you have a tag on a trailer, on a hot dog cart. So they go, nope, you don't need a tag on it unless it has two axles or whatever. Well, you only have a single axle on most of these. So why get a tag? Like in Tennessee, we don't need tags. There's no tags required on trailers. It could be 30 foot long. As long as it doesn't have two axles, you're good to go. So check with your city, county, whatever first. Then make sure before you can go look at it, do they have the title and paperwork? Do they have title? Okay. When I say paperwork, I'm gonna get to that in a minute. It's the bill of sale, but the title you need a title in most states, and probably you do. And they need to be able to hand you a clear title. They may hand you a certificate of origin. Let's say you buy it from a dealer, you know, not a dealer, but a seller in Tennessee. He may have never registered it because he didn't need to. So he's going to have a certificate of origin, a COA, and or a CAO. CAO? Yeah. COO? COO. Certificate of origin. He's going to hand you that, and it's going to say the manufacturer's name. You take that to the county tag agency, and they issue you a title. First title ever. So that works. But if they have no paperwork, be careful unless you already know that you can get a tag. Some cities, counties, tag agencies will actually issue you a tag as long as they inspect it. They'll go, oh, okay, you can claim that it's home built. Okay, you can say, I built this, I don't have a tag. And they'll go, okay, we'll come inspect it. And they'll check it. They'll go, okay, the left blinker, right blinker, tail lights, brake lights, yep, you're good to go. And that's it. DOT approved tires, that's it. And so they'll issue you a tag. I've known of some vendors that have actually gone out, and a lot of these trailers are imported. The actual trailer frame is imported because America doesn't make any like ball bearings anymore. We don't make those for wheels. So we have no factories anymore for that. So all that stuff's made overseas in China, Japan, Indonesia, or Philippines, or Vietnam. So they import these parts and they build you a trailer. Well, Northern Tool and Harbor Freight, you can find them online. You can order online, but you probably have one in your city if you have a big city. You can go to them and buy a trailer. And I've heard of vendors doing this, taking the VIN plate off of the trailer they buy, slap it on the trailer they got, and taking the title from the new trailer and then getting it registered. Now they got a registered trailer. I want you to know, I don't know how legal that is, but I've heard it done. So I'm not encouraging you to do that without checking, but for what it's worth. And a bill of sale. You want a bill of sale because you want to make sure the person that signs the title is the person that owns the cart. So have them sign the seller spot and then have them write you out a bill of sale. That can be written on a napkin. It can say, Bob agrees to sell Ben a 2013 hot dog cart, VIN number such and such, on this date for this amount. Problem solved. Now you got a cart, go in, hand it in, and you got a bill of sale and a title, and now you'll get a new title, you'll pay your taxes on the sale price, and you'll be done. That's the best way to do it. I hope that helps you all. I do want to tell you before you leave, if you have any inclination, like if you know you're going to do this business, if you're going to be in this business, you can join Vendors United. You can go to vendorsunited.com and join us. It's just a smaller group of vendors who are professionals as far as, and you don't have to be yet, but it's probably better if you wait till you know you're going to do this, because it's for vendors who are in the, that want to make the 120, 150, 200,000 a year and up. And so we share information. We have a private Facebook group. We have special stuff for us. And so check that out, vendorsunited.com. Also, check out our Facebook page, facebook.com/Ben's Carts. We have Instagram, and stay in touch with us if you want stuff. I send out a newsletter that's free. You ought to sign up for that. That's at learnhotdogs.com. That may help you out. It'll give you tips and information. You can always search stuff at learnhotdogs.com. If you're interested in a cart, always shop around, okay? I'd never suggest anybody just, oh, okay, I love Ben, I'm going to buy his cart. No, shop around. Hotdogcartstore.com, hotdogcartstore.com. Check it out. And then compare.